Indian troops in their fresh act of state terrorism martyred a Kashmiri youth in Srinagar today. The youth was martyred during a cordon and search operation in Haidarpora area of the city. The operation was going on till the last reports came in. The All Parties Huria Conference has said that India is using military approach to crush the Kashmiris' popular uprising for their inalienable right to self-determination guaranteed by the relevant resolutions of the United Nations Security Council. The APSC spokesman in a statement issued in Srinagar termed the Kashmir dispute as purely a political issue and pointed out that India's reluctance in resolving it politically exposed its imperialistic mindset in occupied Jammu and Kashmir. He made it clear to New Delhi that more than 500,000 people had sacrificed their precious lives, tens of thousands migrated to Pakistan and Azad Kashmir, thousands had illegally been detained, tortured and subjected to enforced disappearance, and numerous women and children rendered widowed and orphaned, while property worth billions of rupees had been vandalized for the only cause of freedom from Indian yoke. Huriyat leaders Khwaja Firdaus of the Samad Inqilabi, Jammu and Kashmir Democratic Freedom Party, Jammu and Kashmir National Front and Jammu and Kashmir Freedom Front, in their statements in Srinagar, voiced serious concern over the ongoing arrest spree, unabated cordon and search operations and transfer of hundreds of canals of land to the Indian paramilitary Central Reserve Police Force in the territory. Meanwhile, Indian troops, in continuation of their terror and harassment operations, barged into many houses in Jamalta area of Srinagar last night and harassed and intimidated the inmates, including women and children. The troops also conducted operations in Shopian, Pulwama, Baramulla, Rajouri and Poonch districts. In Jammu, scores of Congress leaders and activists were arrested by police when they were taking out a protest march towards Governor House against public harassment campaign by the BJP government. The Editors Guild of India and the Indian Women's Press Corps have condemned the detention of two journalists who reported attacks by Hindu extremists associated with Vishwa Hindu Parishad on mosques and shops in Tripura by the Assam police. The Hindutva Brigade, associated with ruling BJP, Bajrang Dal and Vishwa Hindu Parishad, has burnt shops belonging to Muslims in Amravati in Indian state of Maharashtra. In UP, police have registered a sedition case against four Muslims after Hindutva groups alleged that Pakistan flag was hoisted on the rooftop of a house in Mundira Bazar in Gorakhpur city. However, refuting the allegations, the residents of the house told media that the flags they handed over to police had been mistaken for the Pakistan flag. The police also confirmed that no Pakistan flag was found during the search of two houses. Still, FIR was registered against Muslim families. Hundreds of people staged protest in 8 major US cities against Facebook for allowing hate speech to be freely posted in India, resulting in persecution, physical attacks and killing of members of non-Hindu minorities, particularly Muslims. And in view of mounting pressure from Chinese Republican Army in Ladakh and Himachal Pradesh, Indian Army Chief General M.M. Nirvana has left for Israel on a 5-day visit to seek help and advice from the Jewish state on the matter.